Third one, in this video you have one circle and one square, and then radius of the circle is given 1, and side length of the square is given 4 units, and these are given as tangent point. Here is the center point, and the radius of this triangle is asked. First of all, if we connect center of circle with tangent point like this, we know that these are must be equal 90 degrees, right? Because of tangent. So these are also 1 unit because of radius, and here is 1, and this length is also 1 unit, right? Notice that we get a small square. After that, if we connect this 2 point, here must be equal 45 degrees, right? Because of diagonal of the small square. And then if we extend center point like this, this line is also diagonal of the big square, right? So here must be equal 45 degrees. Okay. Then if you focus on this triangle, notice that if there's a 1 unit opposite of 45 degrees, opposite of the 90 degrees, here must be equal root 2, right? Okay. And then we know that here is also 4 units, right? So if there's a 4 unit opposite of the 45 degrees, opposite of the 90 degrees, here must be equal 4 root 2, right? So if here is root 2, that means 3 root 2 left here. Okay. And then let's call here y. For this triangle, if we apply Pythagorean theorem, we get the value of 1, right? So 1 squared plus y squared equal 3 root 2 whole squared. Therefore, 1 plus y squared equal 18. So y squared equal 17. That means y equal root 17. Okay, that's right here. Root 17. After that, here, this length are equal, right? If here is x, that means this part must be equal x unit. Y, let's remind you, if you have a circle and two line, which is tangent like this, this part and this part are equal. Okay. Next step, we know that this side is 4 units, so 3 minus x left here, right? So for this triangle, if we apply Pythagorean theorem, 3 minus x squared plus 4 squared equal x plus root 17 whole squared. Therefore, 9 minus 6x plus x squared plus 16 equal x squared plus 2x root 17 plus 17. Therefore, these are again, so 6x plus 2x root 17 equal 8. And if you divide by 2 both sides of the equation, therefore we get 3x plus x root 17 equal 4. So if we take x parentheses, x times in parentheses 3 plus root 17 equal 4, that means x equal 4 over 3 plus root 17. And if we multiply 3 minus root 17, numerator and denominator, therefore 12 minus 4 root 17 over 9 minus 17. We know that 9 minus 17 equal minus 8. Therefore, x equal minus 3 plus root 17 over 2. Now, we can calculate the area of triangle easily, right? So, triangle area equal 4 times 3 minus x over 2. Let's simplify. Therefore, triangle area equal 6 minus 2x. So, 6 minus 2, we know that x equal minus 3 plus root 17 over 2. These are again, that means triangle area equal 9 minus root 17 unit square. This was the first method. Now we will calculate the area of blue shaded triangle using second method. First of all, let's draw perpendicular and one more. We know that these are one unit because of radius. And here is also one unit, right? And then if we connect these two corners, notice that this angle and this angle are equal, right? So if here is alpha, that means here must be equal alpha, right? Let's remind you again, if we have a circle and two tangent lines like this, these are tangent points and O is center point, and then if we connect these two points, these two angles are equal to each other. Okay. So now, if you focus on blue shaded triangle, this angle here is 180 minus 2 alpha, right? We know that here is 4 units, and let's call here x. That means here must be equal 3 minus x, right? Okay. And then let's clear here. If we calculate tangent 180 minus 2 alpha, tangent 180 minus 2 alpha equal 4 over 3 minus x. And it can be written as minus tangent 2 alpha instead of tangent 180 minus 2 alpha, right? So if we multiply by minus both sides of the equation, therefore, tangent 2 alpha equal 4 over x minus 3. And we know that the expansion of tangent 2 alpha equal 2 times tangent alpha over 1 minus tangent squared alpha equal 4 over x minus 3. After that, if we calculate tangent alpha, notice that tangent alpha equal 1 over x, right? So now, if we plug in this value to the equation, 2 times 1 over x over 1 minus 1 over x whole squared equal 4 over x minus Therefore, 2 over x over x squared minus 1 over x squared equal 4 over x minus 3. So if you simplify the expression, these are again, therefore 2x over x squared minus 1 equal 4 over x minus 3. If we simplify again, so x squared minus 3x equal 2x squared minus 2. X squared plus 3x minus 2 equal 0. So we get a quadratic equation. Let's clear here. If you calculate the delta equal b squared minus 4ac, so 9 minus 4 times 1 times minus 2. Therefore, delta equal 70. So root 1 equal minus 3 minus root 17 over 2. If you notice that first root is less than 0, therefore first root cancel out. Second root equal minus 3 plus root 17 over 2. So this one is greater than 0. That means x equal minus 3 plus root 17 over 2. And the triangle area equal 3 minus x times 4 over 2. If you simplify again, so the area equal 6 minus 2x, right? You know that x equal minus 3 plus root 17 over 2. These are again. Therefore, the blue shaded area equal 9 minus root 17 units squared. Thanks for watching. If you want more videos like this, please don't forget like and subscribe my channel. Take care and bye-bye.